As of August 4th of 2024, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 3 less than were erupting last week. Of these, the only volcano to be currently erupting in the United States is Alaska's remote Great Sitkin volcano. Located in the Aleutian Islands, 26 miles east-northeast of the nearest populated settlement, the Great Sitkin volcano is currently undergoing its longest eruption on record, which has been ongoing for 1,167 days or 3.2 years. In this time span, a very large basaltic andesite lava dome has not only filled the western two-thirds of its summit caldera, but also spilled over and flowed downslope by as much as 3,600 feet. This eruption could continue for multiple more years, further changing the summit topography of the Great Sitkin volcano. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In the Democratic Republic of the Congo, the Nyamuragira shield volcano produced its largest eruption in 13 years, sending fluid lava flows in multiple directions up to 6.5 kilometers or 4 miles from its source vent. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, the Taal volcano erupted 3 times, with each eruption being confined to its highly acidic central crater lake. And, in what is this week's top story, Indonesia's Kelimutu volcano is experiencing its highest level of unrest in more than 50 years, causing notable changes in the appearance of its 3 prominent crater lakes. Located on the island of Flores, the Kelimutu volcano is most well known for its aforementioned highly acidic crater lakes, which heavily are affected by any volcanic unrest, changing in color, temperature, and appearance during these episodes. And Kelimutu has been experiencing such an episode of unrest since May 15th, with this unrest seemingly accelerating since August began. While the unrest initially only affected 2 of Kelimutu's 3 lakes, since July 14th, all 3 lakes have vastly changed in color, with, for example, the Nyamuragira Ta'ai crater going from green to grayish teal to foam blue. Atapolo has experienced even more drastic color changes, going from turquoise to blue-gray and then light and dark brown. All of these color changes are caused by increased hotter than typical geothermal water coming from depth that contains abundant sulfur and associated elements, with this material likely being heated by shallow magma, although probably indirectly. The more particulates that fill these craters, the darker and murkier they become. While all 3 crater lakes have had their temperatures rise, it has been most drastic at Nyamuragira Ta'ai, going from around 33 to 41 degrees Celsius and causing a sustained 100-meter-high degassing plume to rise from it. Alongside this, the rate of volcanic earthquakes has also increased. It is unknown whether this current unrest will result in a phreatic eruption like what was witnessed at this volcano's last eruption in 1968, but regardless, there is a 250-meter exclusion zone in place in all directions around the edge of each crater lake. Heading 2,520 kilometers to the north, the Taal volcano continued its post-2020 pattern of highly frequent phreatic and phreatomagmatic eruptions this week. While sulfur dioxide emissions month over month have actually decreased, nevertheless, Taal produced a 5-minute-long phreatic eruption on August 1st, and then 3 1-minute-long eruptions 1 hour after sunset on August 2nd. These were all confined to its central crater lake, with more infrequent and weak eruptions likely to occur across the next month. Meanwhile, in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, the Nyamuragira volcano produced its largest eruption since 2011. What started as an expansion of its lava lake due to an increased influx of magma on July 11th within a week filled enough of its summit caldera to begin overflowing a low section of its rim. This sent a lava flow 6 kilometers to the north within 24 hours, quickly covering the landscape. While lava continued flowing in the same direction across the next 9 days, lava kept building in volume within the summit caldera, causing it to overflow in a second direction to the west beginning on July 27th. This secondary lava lobe is now advancing at a rate of about 210 meters or 689 feet a day and is still actively expanding. In only 22 days, 2.84 square kilometers has been covered in a layer of lava, which has the potential to reach several small farming communities. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on August 3rd of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Anders Kolande, for supporting this channel.